Hi Pisces, this is your horoscope for 2020. I hope you're having a wonderful time here in 2019. But what I want to do in this video is to just give you an idea of what the main themes are in 2020 for you, Pisces, okay? So that you know what to put your energy into and you know not to waste your energy in other parts of your life, okay? So let's have a look at this. The first thing that is remarkable in 2020 is that there are 6 eclipses, okay? So I know astrologers are always like, oh my God, this is gonna be so intense, but this year is really going to be intense. The first lunar eclipse full moon in Cancer occurs on the 10th of January and it showers you with Cancer energy, nurturing, caring, loving. And it's in your fifth house of romance and relationships. It's a lunar eclipse, so it's interrupted. So this nurturing, loving energy stays with you until June. So you're very attractive to other people. People will resonate with your vibe. If you're single and you want to be in a relationship, no problem. If you're in a relationship, you can charm the socks off anybody. If you don't want to be in a relationship, get creative. Express yourself. Do what it is you love to do. On the 12th of January, Saturn and Pluto conjunct. And that only happens every 34 years. And it happens in your 11th house of hopes and dreams. And Saturn is structure and security. Pluto is transformation and change, rebirth. So they couldn't be any more different. They're 22 degrees, master number of the builder, in Capricorn, the sign of the worker. So what you're able to do is you're able to build your empire. You're able to build your hopes and dreams because of this push that you've been given. You have the energy to now really realize yourself in an actual, tangible, physical way. So what's going on in here, you create a healing center or you have an office or you are a public figure. Whatever it is you want to make out of yourself, you're able to do that. You're able to transform and then have a settled platform from which you can do your stuff, but in the way that you want to do it. Now, I want to give you some key dates here because these dates are really, really important during the year. The first one is the 4th of April, then it's the 30th of June, and then the 12th of November. And these dates are important because Jupiter, the lucky planet of growth and expansion, conjuncts Pluto, transformation, rebirth. These two are much better friends than Saturn and Pluto, okay? Because Jupiter is fun and Pluto is about being a phoenix, rising from the ashes. So on those dates, watch out because you're going to get opportunities to live your dream, to live your passion. Jupiter is lucky. It opens doors of opportunity for you. If you're walking around New York, and Jupiter's on your side, a talent agent sees you buying groceries and wants to book you for his upcoming film. You never know, and the universe has such great things planned for us. Keep those dates in mind and make yourself available. On the 13th of May through until the 25th of June, Venus, the planet of love, beauty, and romance, is in retrograde. And it's in retrograde in your fourth house of family in Gemini at 21 degrees. 2 and 1 is 3. 3 in numerology is communication. So if you have a wedding planned, if you have a plan to launch a new business that you love, if you want to propose to someone you love, it's doing things that you love and making a commitment. When you do that during a Venus retrograde, it's not recommended, because what usually seems bland and uninteresting or even negative to you normally, when the Venus retrograde happens, you start to see them very differently and you start liking those things. And then when the return is over and Venus moves forward again, you're like, what have I just done? So I know that people book wedding venues in advance for years and years, but if you can try and avoid the 13th of May to the 25th of June 2020, that would be best, because I can draw up a chart of when you got married. And if you get married during that period, we've always got a Venus retrograde in the chart, and that always means that love is going to be complicated in that relationship. So try and stay away from that. Now, the first round of eclipses have come and gone. Now, the second round is appearing in June. Remember, the effects last 6 months. So now, in June, on the 5th, we have a lunar eclipse in Sagittarius. And that's in your 10th house of career. So you're going to be showered with Sagittarius energy, which is about making goals and being ambitious and getting there. And it allows you to let go of the things that are worthless and that you chase and that makes no difference to you. And you decide to set goals which actually have a payoff, which are valuable. So you feel very at ease in your work and you naturally set the right goals. You're naturally focusing on the right things. Again, it's an eclipse. So it lasts until the end of the year. So you're going to be really comfortable at work. It's going to be really chill for you at work. So no major changes there. You're also going to be very good with family members, just not during the retrograde. There could be miscommunication. But family is also blessed for you this year. So family really support you, and maybe it's because you have that support that work is so easy. But I don't see anything particularly difficult here. On the 21st of June, we have a solar eclipse, new moon in Cancer. And that happens in your 5th house of romance and relationship. And it pulls down loads of Cancer energy. But it also has Mercury, the communication planet, there in Cancer. So you're able to articulate your love very, very well. And you're able to become much more eloquent. So again, this is the time to hope and dream and to make the dream of romance a reality on the 21st, because that's what it's all about. It showers you with Cancer energy. And remember, the moon builds up and it waxes and it wanes. So it's not just like 1 second. It'll affect you from the 20th, 21st, 22nd of June 2020. On the 5th of July, we have another eclipse. It's crazy. This is a lunar eclipse, full moon in Capricorn, on the North Node. Jupiter, Pluto, and Saturn join the moon in Capricorn in your 11th house. So what's going to happen is that this is another opportunity to, or the universe is hammering home the message that if you dream it, if you hope, if you desire it, you're going to be so comfortable at work that you can transform things and make them so that you love the work that you do and you have the potential to really find love in another human being. So love at work and love in your personal life, those are big themes, and hopes and dreams being realized, those are the themes for you in 2020. So that's a really good year. So this energy is going to continue for the rest of the year, okay? So love and hopes and dreams being realized, don't be surprised if that happens. It's in the stars and they support you in that area. And that continues until the 30th of November, because then we have another eclipse. I've got the chart here in front of me. I'm sorry, I'm just trying to get to the exact day, the 30th of November. We've got a lunar eclipse, full moon in Gemini. And that happens in your fourth house of family. So what happens with this is it's an eclipse. So the effects are going to last 6 months into April 2021. And the gift that you're being given here is that you're really able to communicate with spirit and your family in a loving, beautiful way. So you get much more support from family and you're able to, it's like a safety net, or it gives you a platform from which you can realize your hopes and dreams. But it goes into next year, so it's not, you know, it's not that relevant for 2020, because it really just enters the next year. On the 14th of December as well, we have a total solar eclipse, so the sun's going to be totally blacked out, and it's a new moon in Sagittarius. But again, this is now going to last until May 2021. And for you, it's in your 10th house in Sagittarius. So it's about making changes. Maybe work was too boring for you, because at the beginning of the year, work was really easy and effortless. And maybe you're not challenged enough. Maybe you want something more exciting. Maybe you want to earn more money. Maybe you want to change. This total solar eclipse also has your transiting midheaven, which is work, and Mercury, the communication planet, in there. So the transformation and Sagittarius pointing his bow and arrow at a specific goal, that's what's going to happen from the 14th of December going into May 2021, and you're really going to be looking at making changes in your career then. Something really important happens on the 21st of December. It's called the Great Conjunction, and it only happens once every 20 years. So it happened in 2001, where we had 9/11. It happened in 1981, where we had the birth of HIV/AIDS. In 2021, we're going to have a massive shift. Because whenever this great conjunction appears, it tests humanity. It tests our society. So 9/11, that changed the way people fly forever. HIV/AIDS, that killed millions of people and changed the way people behaved, and society was affected. Do you see what I mean? It's something that was a non-issue suddenly becomes an issue, and that's what's going to happen in 2021. I've meditated on this so much and I haven't got the answer. First I got artificial intelligence was going to take over, then I got climate change, that we were going to ruin the planet and we would have to change our thoughts to rebuild the planet. And then I got like enlightenment from people, that people would just suddenly hop to the next level of human evolution. But none of those give me that ding, 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 ding feeling. So I'm not quite sure. What I am sure of is that there's a fundamental societal shift which starts on the 21st of December 2020. And it starts a whole new era. So that's what I get for you in 2020. I hope it gives you certain areas to ponder on, and maybe it gives you some encouragement to make changes so that you can live your best life if you're not satisfied in your job. And I've just said it seems too easy and you need a challenge. Maybe you can do that earlier then, if you're in that situation. So if you would like a private session with me, then please get in touch via my website. It's gregoryscott.com. Click on the readings tab to order your reading. In my personal readings, I use your date of birth, place of birth, and time of birth. And it's a very specific snapshot of the sky at the moment you were born. This chart is for all Pisces. So it's not going to be anywhere near as accurate as your personal chart. Because, wait, if you don't have the time of birth, then please order a chart rectification with me. There's a process where I can work out the time of birth. It's really important because the chart changes every 4 minutes. Once I have those details, date of birth, place of birth, and time of birth, I can draw up a blueprint, your natal chart. And that is really a blueprint of your soul. It shows me where you've been in past lifetimes, what your life purpose is in this lifetime, what your vocational aptitudes are, and whether they're linked to your life purpose. Love, romance, money, where to live, where the best place is to live, when to move. I can answer any questions you've got if you are wondering if you're compatible with someone. I can do a synastry reading where I compare your charts. So get in touch. I can really answer anything that might be on your mind. I hope you have a lovely 2020. Check out some of my other videos, the daily tarot readings, the weekly horoscopes for all signs of the zodiac, the monthly horoscopes for each specific sign of the zodiac. If you like this video, please hit the subscribe button and share the video online if you're feeling generous. I'm sending you lots of kisses. Mwah! And I'll speak to you soon.